Good evening. Welcome to Tuesday, the 7th of February, evening prayer. And there's going to be quite a bit of a theme about listening in the reading. So I think we'll just take a moment to be quiet. I guess there'll be all kinds of noises around you. I've got the hum of the fridge here and I can hear people next door a little bit. But I think we need to, above all that, have an open ear to you, Lord. So let's pray and come to God in the silence and let him speak to us. Be still and know that I am God. And as we hear your voice, Lord, let us exalt you, as it says in that psalm, exalt you in the nations, let us exalt you in our hearts. Speak to us tonight through words and prayer, through music. Help us to listen to what you say. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. So we're going to look today at Ezekiel chapter 2. 1 to 10.
Ezekiel chapter 2. The Lord said to me, Son of man, stand up on your feet and I will speak to you. As he spoke, the Spirit came into me and raised me to my feet and I heard him speaking to me. He said, Son of man, I am sending you to the Israelites, to a rebellious nation that has rebelled against me. They and their fathers have been in revolt against me to this very day. The people to whom I am sending you are obstinate and stubborn. Say to them, this is what the Sovereign Lord says. And whether they listen or fail to listen, for they are rebellious, they will know that a prophet has been among them. And you, son of man, do not be afraid of them or their words. Do not be afraid, though briars and thorns are all around you and you live among scorpions. Do not be afraid of what they say or terrified by them, though they are a rebellious house. You must speak my words to them, whether they listen or fail to listen, for they are rebellious. But you, son of man, listen to what I say to you. Do not rebel like that rebellious house. Open your mouth and eat what I give you. And I looked and saw a hand stretched to me. In it was a scroll, which he unrolled to me. On both sides of it were written the words of lament and mourning and woe.
So this is quite hard for Ezekiel, isn't it? God saying, go to speak. Whatever the audience, some listen, but many won't. Many will not. Strangely, they'll know, says the passage, that there's been a prophet among them. So it's not really that they don't listen, as they don't understand. They do understand something special has been said. They just don't want it. So it's a picture of rebellious people. That's what it says, doesn't it? They don't get it. They don't want it. And what the passage says is, okay, the people aren't going to listen, but you, son of man, you listen. And that means not to them, but to God. When I preach or talk or anything, when I do evening prayers, how much of my words are a result of listening to God? I mean, I have to ask myself that. Well, how many is just, God, we better get an idea down here. You know, you really need to weigh the things that you hear in the churches, in Bible studies, in evening prayers. You know, is this God talking? And to each of us, as I said in the opening prayers, the important thing is God is saying the same thing to us. It says, do not rebel like the rebellious people. That's now God's talking to Ezekiel now. Open your mouth and eat what I give you. So that's, you know, you've got to do my message. And that is what he's being asked to do. Listen and receive. So let's pray for a second. Lord, we would hardly want it that we would be sent to a very poor mission field. Go and take that assembly, go and lead that group, go and speak in the marketplace. Nobody's going to listen to you, but, you know, do it. So difficult. And sometimes we are doing that even in the churches, Lord. We're sharing, we're leading, we're whatever we do, so little result. Lord, we cannot be responsible for other people. But we can be responsible for saying we will listen to you. So in our sphere of influence, help us know sometimes we must just keep saying what is true. And then remember to replenish that, to refresh that message by listening to you. We pray this prayer in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. I don't know if you'll know this song at all that I'm about to play. We used to sing it quite a bit at Open Door in Deeping in those days. And it's called Just One Touch from the King by Godfrey Birtle. But it has, I've chosen it because it has a refrain in the middle. Oh land, oh land, oh land. It's talking to really the UK. Hear the word of the Lord. You know, talk about a mission field that might not be listening. We still need to do it, don't we? And then the refrain is that it's when we're touched by God that makes all the difference. Listen, receive. So let's listen to Godfrey and join in Just One Touch from the King. I'll see you tomorrow on Wednesday.
This battle raging over this land, a deep damage in the people. Pride stops us stretching out our withered hand, yet God has stretched out to heal us. This I know, this I know, this I know. Changes everything. a deep darkness on the people, but a light is shining and that the dark can't understand. Light of the world, King Jesus, do you know? Just one touch from the King. Change.